All right, when you're up for a new job, typically you'll face interview questions, the standard things, right? Like, what are your greatest strengths? What are your weaknesses? Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Well, let's change the game a little bit. A marketing company out in Connecticut, they decided to do what's called a snowflake test to weed out those so-called whiny millennials. So the questions that they're a little outside of the box. For example, here are some of the questions asked in that survey. What does America mean to you? What does privilege mean to you? When was the last time you cried and why? So the owner of this company says that they were looking to find people that are proud of who they are, not entitled, and have a big heart. All right, so it's sparking a huge conversation, one that comes up a lot. Millennials are more a part of the workforce than ever before. So like it or not, companies are having to adapt to this new mind frame, a new way of thinking. But there are also things that millennials can do to avoid that whiny stereotype. Let's bring in Don Strankowski. He is the president of Ascend Career and Life Strategies, here to talk about some ways to coexist.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm fantastic. Thank you.
So first of all, you took a look at some of these questions.
I did look at the questions, yes.
So, as you know, what do you do if a coworker comes to the table with an idea and it sucks? These are questions here. What do you think about police? What do you think about guns? What did you think about this survey?
You know, it's kind of interesting, Megan, because, you know, as we mentioned, millennials are now the number one demographic in today's U.S. workforce. And, you know, some of the anecdotes have led to the stereotypes about showing up to interviews in flip-flops, maybe accompanied by a parent, and they want a quick ascension up the corporate ladder, and job hopping is all the norm. And maybe there's an iota of truth to that. But, you know, millennials bring a lot to the table in terms of creativity and innovation. They've really taken teamwork to the next level also. But when you have a work environment and you have millennials and Gen Xers like me and baby boomers, it can cause a bit of a culture clash.
Yeah, where did this stereotype come from? Millennials are lazy and they're snowflakes. And by the way, what is a snowflake? How do you define it?
A snowflake, I guess, it would be somebody who's overly sensitive to work issues or maybe political issues or personal issues and things of that nature. Hence, why the CEO came up with the survey he asked people, which I don't really think is 100% necessary. But there are some things that millennials can do at work to coexist with their Gen X counterparts like me or baby boomers, right?
So how do we get along?
How do we all get along? We can all get along, Megan, absolutely. So number one, stand up and speak out. Now, I've coached a fair number of millennials the last 7 to 8 years, and I have noticed that maybe the assertiveness gene might not be quite as pronounced as their Gen X or baby boomer counterparts. So if they want the raise, if they want that additional project, and especially in a job interview, ask for it. Make it known. Don't just feel that it needs to be offered to you or get upset if you get overlooked. Another thing that they can do is actually seek out a mentor, and that was so prominent in my career. Most executive and management level positions are still held by Gen Xers and baby boomers, so finding a sage to kind of help you navigate that corporate ladder, that would be fantastic, a fantastic career move also. And then one more thing that millennials can do is really focus on the logo on that paycheck. It's not all about you or the person, it's about the organization, it's about bottom line results, and at the end of the day, generating revenue or working on those company goals. So millennials really need to stay focused on the task at hand at work on the whole.
Very good advice there, Dan Strankowski. Thank you so much. See, millennials, Gen Xers, we can all get along.
We can all get along. We can all do it, absolutely.
See, thank you so much.
Thank
good stuff there. All right, let's send it over to another millennial. Greg, where are you at?
I am not a millennial, by the way.
Yes, you are,
I do not believe that I am in that, and I will let you know that I dress professionally every day when I come to work.